Many designers use mesh gradients in their designs to burst with some cool colors. In this video, we're gonna create some mesh gradients, and if you want to detail it even more, I will also show you how to animate them. Plus, in the working file, you have 9 free meshes gradients that you can use in your work. So, let's start. The simplest way to add gradients into your designs is by simply using a plugin. You can download the mesh gradient plugin that is super user-friendly. You can adjust these handles to create and use the button randomize to create infinite gradients. This is a simple and fast method that you can use. The problem with this is that the asset we get is a PNG, so later on, if you want to adjust some colors, you are unable to do it. But I know that you are here to know how to create one from scratch, so let's go. Start by hit F on keyboard to open up the frames and grab the desktop frame. Now let's set some background colors. You may see that I have already here some created, so let's pick one. Next up, let's create our shapes. Select the pen tool and draw random shapes all over your frame to apply the colors we have here. Delete the strokes, add fill colors, and adjust shapes. I will fast forward this part. Okay, I think it's done. Now, check if the frame has already the clip content box checked, so anything that goes outside the frame will not be visible. Now we need to apply the blurs to see the mesh effect we want to create. So shift click in all shapes and add an effect here that's called layer blur, and go here to blur settings and increase the blur to a value that you consider it fits your needs. You may see that I'm increasing the blur by 10, so if you hold shift plus arrow up or down, it jumps from 10 to 10 our values. Cool, huh? And there you have it. If this is the result you need, the mesh gradient is done. But you can aim more for a different work and want to add some texture, details, or even animate it. In that case, keep following along. And before you go, right after it, if you haven't already liked or subscribed, I will be very happy if you do so. Alright, let's go. To add texture, you need to find in the Figma community someone who is sharing a noise texture image. You can use this one that is in the working file that you may find in the video description down below. And then, let's bring the image to the frame and ensure it's on top of all layers. So copy and paste this image to inside our frame, adjust to cover all the image, and let's go here to settings. Change the blend mode to overlay and decrease the opacity once again to something you like. I think I will go with 10%. And now let's add some bright spots. And these are some interest spots that you can use to pop out in the image. And now let's add some bright spots. And these are some interested spots that you can use to pop out in the image. And to create this is as simple as our shapes. So create an ellipse. Change the color to white and blend mode to color dodge. Add a layer blur to the ellipse. Increase the blur to something like this. We can also pick from a color from the main frame. And what this effect will do is that when I move the rectangle on top of another color, it will brighten the part of the image. Now you can see that this is getting really cool, so let's move to the next step, animate this mesh. Let's click here on top to make this frame a component, and then hit again here on plus to add a variant, and here down below, click plus again to add another one. Now we can change the name of the properties to first frame, then the second one as second frame, and then the third one as third frame. And we can use for this example these three properties, first, second, and third one. Now let's move some effects to other positions. So here in the second frame, You should hide the texture image in the layers panel to be able to work with these shapes. Then let's adjust some shapes to move them around. And then put back the texture visible again. Then let's do the same for the third frame. Okay, when everything is done, let's prototype. So head up here to prototype, select the first frame and link to second frame. In the settings, you set to after delay of 1 millisecond to be almost instant, and then change the animation to smart animate and set the end to linear with 3000 milliseconds. And now let's repeat the same for the other frames and make sure the settings are all the same. Then do the same link from the third one to the first one and check if the settings are okay, so that we can have the cycle of this animation. Now go back to design, grab the instance of our mesh gradient, set as flow starting point, and now we can go to see our animation. So hit play to run, and you can see that it's really, really nice. You can see this animation going around our mesh gradient. Now you have here a bonus page that I've created for you, so you can go here to free meshes pages, and you have a set of meshes that you can use and also change colors and positions to apply into your work. Pretty cool, huh? And that's it. If you found this video helpful, give a thumbs up, share it with your fellow designers, and don't forget to subscribe for more insightful content. Thank you and have a great day.